Besides that, I think that the midfield play was slightly in Mike Rule's favor, ever so slightly. And you know, people saying kickoff goals, yeah, kickoff goals doesn't count. Kickoff goals are, you know, the make or break of 1v1. If you don't have a good kickoff, then you're going to struggle. Oh, is Mike a carbon fiber? I believe he does. Beautiful. That's exactly what the carbon fiber white is something that I was rocking a couple of days ago, before I actually disenchanted this decal because I'm a fool. The racer decal is like, I don't need this. Oh wait, no! I wish I didn't get rid of that. The title should be updated. It should say Mike Rule versus Scrub Killer. It should say Mike Rules versus Scrub Killer. So Mike actually missing one of the boost pads there. I'm not sure if that was a mistake or just he wanted to take the most efficient line straight to the ball. Mike's perhaps one of the best players in the world at looking around with his camera swivel to try and spot out the other player. Scrub going for the demo that whole time, but he couldn't catch up. Who won the last matches out of Kronovi and Cux? Kronovi won the first... Well, Kronovi won three of the first four matches, and then Cux won the next five in a row. So another kickoff goal for Scrub. Mike not able to get a solid contact on the ball as Scrub is. This is something that we see a lot when Scrub's playing, because his kickoff is just so, so well executed. Probably the most deadly kickoff in 1v1 in the world. But speaking of deadly, Mike Rules from the ground, he knows the moment that ball's bouncing, and look at that, the timing is just on point, really well done. Right after the ball bounces, he goes for that hit because he wants to get the upward momentum on the ball before making the connection to get the height on the shot. So Mike, I'm expecting him to just come down the well with this. Oh, well done, actually getting the shot before Scrub Killer thought. Scrub giving him a what a play, sick in the chat. I think Scrub thought Mike was just going to take a touch, but suddenly, out of nowhere, just front flip, shot in the net. Scrub not respecting that angle. Oh, I'm surprised Mike flipped at that ball, actually giving Scrub a shot, but he did get back in time to cover the angle. Oh, Scrub just got bumped. He's probably falling. Okay, he actually had some boost to fly back down with. Really good recovery by Scrub Killer. Missing the mid boost, though. Does get the back one. Not a scoreable angle by Scrub. Mike, again, swiveling his camera just to keep an eye on Scrub Killer. Making sure that he doesn't do anything cheeky. And speaking of cheeky, will we see... Oh, no, we're not going to see a wormy goal attempt by Mike. And that's not the wall hit that he was looking for. Definitely looking to get more of a solid contact. Oh, rip Mike Rule, Scrub getting the kill. Mike was trying to like get in front of Scrub here, just so he could get the ball to the side of the net, but got a little bit bumped and then just gets completely obliterated. So Mike still with a big advantage, but again, fourth kickoff goal in two games, second kickoff goal in this game, just... Scrub is so good at these. You notice how he positions his car slightly to the side of the ball. He tries to mirror his opponent. So right here we see Mike approaching the ball from the left-hand side of the pitch from Scrub's perspective. Scrub also tries to hit the ball from the left-hand side. And that's why he's able to win kickoffs consistently. He gets his car on the same side of the ball as the other player, hits the ball first, and side flips into it. And that way his car is like basically a moving wall. His car just continually blocks the angle that the other player is trying to hit it in. And he does it so well. It's not easy to do. You can try it yourselves, and when you get it to work, you'll be amazed how, you know, much you can dominate kickoffs. But it is not easy. The consistency that Scrub's able to show with that kickoff strategy is quite impressive. As someone who's tried to do it many times, I would definitely say it is not easy. Mistake by Mike here. The only reason to go for this shot is if you have a read that Scrub doesn't have boost, but Scrub had, as we saw, plenty boost. You know, he wasn't wasting boost on previous saves. You can only really go for that aerial hit if you've previously taken, you know, a couple or three maybe ground shots and your opponent has been using boost to save all of them without having time to drive forward and collect more pads. But Scrub didn't have to do that. He just sat on the goal line with the boost that he'd previously collected. So Mike going up for the aerial above crossbar height, definitely a misplay. Beautiful recovery by here, right here by Mike though. You notice pinging the ball into the roof in the corner. It's a good way to get the ball to center because it kind of rolls into the ceiling and then down into the center. Best way to block Scrub's kickoff? Well, Mike just needs to hit the ball more from his goal side and try to hit it more central as well. If he hits the ball more from his goal side, and by that I mean Mike needs to try and get his car between his goal and the ball when he hits it on kickoff, because if he doesn't do that, then Scrub's going to force it past him. Another mistake by Scrub though. Mike able to capitalize on a whiff defensively. But you see what's happening is just Scrub is getting there quicker, he's hitting the ball to the side, then Mike hits it forward, and then Scrub's car has moved into the position that Mike's hitting it into. You see right there, the ball's going from Scrub to Mike, then Scrub's car has then moved into the position where the rebound is going to go. So if Mike doesn't speed up his kickoff or, you know, predict which way Scrub's hitting it to, this is going to continue to happen. Right there though, bang in the middle. Just what I said, you know, putting his car right between the ball and the goal. He did a kickoff goal, Mike! Acknowledging in chat that he actually scored a kickoff goal. Yeah, the Kronovi vs. Cux series finished off 6-3 to Kronovi, 6-3 to Cuxer. Kronovi starting off very well and Cux just finishing strongly. Oh, well done by Scrub. Mike actually not able to get a touch on this ball. Oh, that's the touch that really put Mike in trouble. And then I think Mike very, very nearly got that goal. We'll watch a couple of kickoffs from Scrub's perspective. This is not the best one to look at because both players coming dead on makes it hard to know which side of the ball Mike is going to approach from. That's really where the strength of Scrub's kickoff lies, is he tries to predict which side of the ball his opponent is going to approach it from. And he mirrors it, beats them to it, and side flips across the ball, like hitting it very, very central and hard. Yeah, that was a really nice demo. Scrub saying square go. So right here, I'm expecting Scrub to flip it to the far side of the pitch, like that, and then side flip, like that, and then get the kickoff goal, like that. So it's exactly what I said. You know, he just puts himself on the same side of the pitch as his opponent, which is the right side. Side flips so that when Mike hits it, Scrub's like basically made a wall that is impassable. He's probably going to flip into the right side of the pitch here unless he gets a read. Okay, so he expected Mike to be, you know, approaching the ball from the other side of the pitch. I don't know why. I thought he would just do the same thing as last time. Oh, Mike getting a bit of revenge from the previous demolish. Dribbles the ball towards the boost. Will he go for a dribble play? No, just a power slide shot. Mike likes shooting above dribbling in high level 1v1. Scrub getting another demo though. This has really turned quite ugly. Mike had a 2-goal cushion and now Scrub with a 2-goal cushion. Really nice demolish. So let's see, will he go left side of the pitch? Yep, and then side flip into the right. This time though, Mike pretty much did the exact same thing. But you see why it's so effective. Like, as the ball is bouncing between them, the car is kind of following the ball. Because the first connection that Scrub makes on the ball is dictating which way the ball is going to move from the center. And his car moves along with it. Scrub with the revenge bump. He actually caught Mike right on his jump. That's brutal. Right as Scrub hit Mike, Mike had just jumped off the ground, so he got bashed further. That's really brutal. But we'll watch some kickoffs from Mike's perspective and maybe figure out what he could do differently if he wants to have more success. We've seen Mike giving the triple nice shot to Scrub after Scrub completely bonks the open net. But Mike needs to hurry this one up if he wants to have a chance to win. Good delayed flip. Notice how he air rolled forward into that throw to get the ball to throw forward. It was a really nice air roll into flick by Mike. Top right corner shot maybe. Bit off target. And Mike does not have time to be wasting. This is going to be game. This is the Mike Rule style, though. He likes to just go for grind shots in the top corner. What a peach, man. Absolutely. Mike giving Scrub the great clear in the chat. Scrub will be disappointed that he didn't save this. He was very, very close, which is honestly very impressive. Very impressive that he got close to that. Oh, Mike's had enough. Two games is enough for Mike. But you know, for as far as kickoffs go, that's really the difference between these two players. Mike definitely able to go even with Scrub in midfield play. Once the play develops into, you know, two players battling for possession, they were pretty evenly matched, with Mike maybe having a slight edge, especially in game one. But the kickoff goals were the difference, and so long as Mike doesn't learn how to, you know, do a kickoff similar to Scrub's, or find a kickoff that counters it, perhaps like a slow kickoff that blocks his kickoff, Scrub's kickoff more effectively. Because arriving slightly after Scrub does and hitting the ball right after him is not the solution. But you know, kickoff goals are something that none of us like to see. And the bumps may be getting to Mike's head as well. You know, let's be honest, maybe he just had to go. He did tell me that he could, when I asked Mike if he could play, he just said, yeah, I can do a few games really quickly. So he probably just had time for a couple of games and he had to go.